You have a complete, very high precision built-in measuring system for frequency response, for delay, and for the phase response built in your DSP. You can activate it with Alt plus M, and here comes an overview over the main functions and buttons in the GUI. Okay, at first. Get the GUI. At first you see there is a free space in the left menu structure. If you press Alt and M, you become a warning because the measuring tones of the signal generator can destroy your speaker. You have to know what you do. You have to accept. Then you can install the Mosconi own measuring signals, the sine sweep on your desktop. I press OK, and then I have a folder on my Windows desktop with the measuring signals, the sine sweeps. I show you they are always the same sweep, but with different volumes from 0 dB, the loudest sweep, to -30 dB, very quiet sweep. Okay, now if you have done this, you have a new button in your GUI, the measure button. If you enter the measure sheet, you see the signal generator, the measure config, the time delay measuring, and the measure menu. And I explain you the different parts of the measuring GUI. At first, warning, if you have or if you want to connect the microphone by a wrong setting, you can create a Lersen effect. In German, say Rückkopplung, a feedback from the speaker to the microphone, and this may destroy your speaker. Never connect the microphone to an input of the amplifier or the DSP who is routed to the speaker. Okay, the first menu is the built-in signal generator. You can generate each standard noise or sound or measuring signal for the built-in measuring system or any external measuring system. You can create a Dirac and white noise and pink noise, our sine sweep, or you can use an external source. So if you want to check your OMK stereo or something else. The important buttons are the buttons Start and Set Mixer. Set Mixer, you have to know the built-in signal generator can connect to the input 7 and 8. So if you want to use the signal generator, you have to route input 7 and 8 to all outputs. In this way, if you press the button Set Mixer, exactly this happens. Your mixer is set to all inputs on 7 and 8. All trigger functions are deactivated and the old mixer settings are stored in a buffer. So if you press Set Mixer again, your old mixer settings are restored. This is the first button. Important, if you have connected a microphone on input 7 and 8 with the button Set Mixer, you route the microphone to the speakers and then you get a Lersen effect. Okay, the next button is the Start button. The Start button start the selected test tone and it switch the input 7 and 8 away from the normal input to the signal generator. This switch will be moved with the button start. Okay, in this way you can try it. You can create any test tone to your speakers. You can create an Dirac pulse. An Dirac pulse is a very small needle pulse to measure the polarity and the time delay. It's a tick, 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 tick. You will hear it. You can create a white noise. A white noise is not recommended to do any acoustic measuring with speakers, because the white noise contains the full energy from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So your mid-range and your tweeter become the full energy of the sound pressure level and can be damaged. So use the white noise only for electrical measurements frequency response. The pink noise is the normal noise to measure speaker systems, because the energy decreases to higher frequencies. So your mid-range and your tweeters are safe against too much power. The sine sweep you only need in our built-in measuring system. The sine sweep you need for the measuring of frequency response and phase response. And if you want to use the measuring system with an external source, you have to choose external source. So you can burn the sine sweeps. The test tones on a CD, can play it in your head unit and can use this as measuring signal. The next box is the measuring config. In the measuring config you choose on which point in the DSP you want to measure the response. If you choose any input, the measuring is directly at the electrical input of your DSP or DSP amplifier. If you have a DSP product with more than 10 inputs, you press the button input 9 and 10 again and it switch to 11, 12 or switch to 13, 14. I show you. Input 9 and 10, input 11, 12, input 30, 14. Okay, that's the one option, directly at the input of the DSP. You use this option for acoustical measurements with a microphone, or if you want to measure the frequency response of your head unit. The next option is you can measure on the output of the mixer any group. So it's this point between the mixer and the main equalizer. You can measure in front of the front equalizer, in front of the rear equalizer, and so on. And in this way you can measure, for example, if you have mixed together an active system, you can check the correct summing of your signal. You can measure the influence of your input equalizer and your input filters, so you have to measure behind the mixer. An important button is the mic connected button. This button mute all inputs and opens it only for measuring if you have a microphone connected. In this way you can prevent the Larsen effect, because the inputs are not routed audible to the speaker outputs. The next menu is the time delay measuring, the manual time delay measuring menu. I explain you how the time delay measuring works. It's a simple timer and very high precision, but simple timer with you can start it and you can stop the timer, and from one channel deliver the start pulse and the other channel deliver the stop pulse. In this configuration, the start pulse is set to right, so the right channel, the Dirac pulse of the right channel, start the counter. The counter run and run and run and run and run, measure the time. And if the Dirac pulse is measured on the left channel, it's 2, here you set the stop pulse, the timer stops. And this delay in milliseconds between the start pulse and the stop pulse, the measuring machine shows you in the pattern above. It's calculate the delay in milliseconds to the distance and to the internal sample. And for example, if you have the wrong polarity of one channel, this Dirac pulse will go to the negative, to down. And in this case, if the time delay machine detect at the negative pulse at first, it shows you the wrong phase. Otherwise, in this example, it shows you the polarity is right, the phase is okay. If you choose a start pulse, the middle button, the Dirac button, the internal signal generator will create the start pulse. Okay, at last you have the menu measure with the button RTR sign sweep. The RTA measuring starts, so the internal sign sweep generator creates the sign sweep to measure. The configuration switch to frequency response measuring and the measure starts. Clear sheet and redraw. Clear the whole sheet and redraw only the last measuring. The microphone calibration we talk about later. And you have the margin button measure RTA, or it can switch to measure time. With this button you switch between the frequency phase response sheet or the semi-automatic time delay measuring. I'll show you. If you push this button, the measure page switch from one to the other and back.